Today, we will use the iPhone 16 Pro Max, paired with the latest 25 watts MagSafe charger, to conduct a magnetic wireless charging test. Apple's official website claims that when it is paired with a 30 watts charger, it can provide 25 watts of wireless output power, which can charge the iPhone 16 and iPhone 16 Pro to half capacity in 30 minutes. We have previously tested the wireless charging power in the iPhone 16 Plus charging review. The power at the input end can reach around 28 to 29 watts. It is much higher than the old MagSafe charger and Qi 2. The appearance has not changed much, except that the cable has been changed to a woven one, which is more durable. The length of the cable is 1 meter. It can support input of 5 volts 3 amps, 9 volts 3 amps, and 15 volts 3 amps. Like wired charging, it supports 15 volts PD fast charging. When using a PD charger with a power of 30 watts or above and the new MagSafe charger to charge the iPhone 16 Pro Max, the input voltage is about 15 volts, the current is about 2 amps, and the power is between 28 to 29 watts. When using this 25 watts MagSafe to charge the iPhone 16, the power is lower than that of the large size Pro Max. Under normal circumstances, it is around 23 watts. It can reach around 25 watts when the screen is turned on, and the voltage is always maintained at 15 volts. When using it to charge 15 series, the voltage can only reach 9 volts, and the input power is about 18 watts. Next, we'll use the MagSafe charger with an Apple 30 watts charger to fully charge the iPhone 16 Pro Max, and put them into a 25 degrees Celsius thermotank throughout the test. The voltage is around 15 volts at first, and the charging curve can be divided into 5 parts. In the first part, the peak power stays at 29 watts for the first 5 minutes. Then, the power gradually drops to 21 watts, 10 watts, and 4 watts in turn. At 39 minutes, the voltage drops from 15 volts to 9 volts briefly, and then increases to 15 volts. At 55 minutes, the voltage drops from 15 volts to 9 volts. The final part begins at 1 hour and 16 minutes, the power slowly drops to almost zero. During this process, the voltage drops to 5 volts. It takes 2 hours and 23 minutes to be fully charged. We also turn it into another curve. The new MagSafe charger can charge the iPhone 16 Pro Max to 50% in 34 minutes. And it can reach 80% in 1 hour and 10 minutes, 100% in 2 hours and 23 minutes. Using the iPhone 16 Pro Max wired charging curve as a reference, it takes 2 hours and 20 minutes to fully charge, which is only 3 minutes faster than the 25 watts MagSafe. Since wireless charging generates a lot of heat, temperature is something everyone is concerned about. So, we recorded the highest temperature on the front and back after charging for 15 minutes, 30 minutes, and 50 minutes. After 15 minutes of charging, the maximum temperature of the contact surface between the phone and the wireless charger is 41.2 degrees Celsius. At this time, the charging power is about 21 watts. After 30 minutes of charging, the maximum temperature is 39.4 degrees Celsius. After 50 minutes of charging, the maximum temperature is 39.3 degrees Celsius. At this time, the charging power is about 10 watts. Compared with the maximum temperature of wired charging, which is only around 37 degrees Celsius, its temperature is much higher. The 25 watts MagSafe charger has significantly improved charging speed. The charging speed is basically at the level of wired charging, and it can charge 50% in 34 minutes. But the temperature is still high. For Apple users who want to experience high-power wireless charging, this new 25 watts MagSafe charger is the best choice. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you next time. Bye.